Hi, everyone. Welcome to another edition of North Shore Journal. I'm your host, Walt Kosmowski, and I have a very special guest with me today, Mr. Leighton O'Connor.
Hey, Walt.
And hi, Leighton. Oftentimes people are said, there are certain individuals that are said to have the perfect job. And I think Leighton O'Connor is probably one of those people. And what I mean by that, you've heard people say where they have their avocation or their hobby or their passion, and they're able to take that and to create a business, a profitable business, and a career for themselves. And that goes for two of Leighton's passions. And I think by looking behind us, you can see what one of them might be, and that is sailing. And the other one is photography and videography. And I think with that introduction, we'll move on and talk to Leighton a little bit. So Leighton, tell us a little bit about how your interest in sailing came about. How young were you? What sort of things did you do?
Thanks for having me, by the way, Walt. Mm-hmm. I guess sailing started on a lake in Westford, where I grew up. I was born in Beverly, but grew up in Westford and moved back to Beverly about 20 years ago. But it started on Forge Village Pond in Beverly on a sunfish and moved into some bigger boats as I got older, and actually started racing probably when I was about 25 or so. I started in photography about 15 or 16 and interviewed with Sports Illustrated at 17. So I've always been in photography, and I finally combined the two passions probably about 10 years ago.
Mm-hmm. And when you say you combine them, so what happened 10 years ago that fused these two interests together?
Well, I had a sailboat. My kids didn't like the sailboat, so I wanted to get a powerboat. So I'm thinking, how can I write off a powerboat? So I went to the bank and I said, listen, this is my business idea. I want to buy a heavy-duty inflatable rib, all new digital gear, because that's when digital photography was coming out. And I want to start a business photographing boats. But I didn't start off photographing racing boats. I started photographing tall ships like the Friendship, which I was a volunteer on. And I was photographing tall ships, schooners, started a greeting card company, doing shows. But I wasn't making a lot of profit at it. Mm-hmm. So I decided to switch to sailboat racing, which I'm not sure why I didn't do it in the first place, because mm-hmm. I had been racing on and off since I was 25, mm-hmm. and I started shooting sailboat races.
Well, now, so when you were first shooting the tall ships, this was simply for the images, and you were sort of like a freelancer, and
correct.
You would try to sell your images to
correct.
Magazines.
Magazines. I was doing greeting cards. I was doing fine art, big canvas prints.
Okay.
That type of thing.
Okay. And so how did you then decide, what came into your mind to kind of merge the photography with the racing part of it?
Because I wasn't finding a huge revenue stream with shooting the schooners, because everybody was doing it. It's easy to shoot a schooner, more or less, because it's big and it doesn't move too fast, and mm-hmm. you just get a boat and get in front of it mm-hmm. and make prints. Mm-hmm. And then I was out one day and I was watching the race, and I said, why am I shooting racing? Mm-hmm. So I got back into racing and started shooting the racing. Mm-hmm.
So tell us about the first few times you videographed or photographed races. What was the first couple of experiences?
I think it was probably out here in Beverly Harbor shooting one of the Jubilee races.
Mm-hmm.
And I wasn't very good at it. I was really far away and not getting the action, not capturing the action, but I kept on, retuning myself and looking at my images and working and working and shooting and shooting and shooting.
Mm-hmm. And now, I guess to fast forward, you are now covering some of the most prestigious regatta races in the world and I asked you this earlier in my naivety, these are actually the World Cup sort of boats that you actually photograph. Is that correct?
That sounds kind of impressive.
Yeah.
And I guess it's somewhat true. I am photographing some of the bigger races around the world. The Volvo Ocean Race, which is a 35,000-mile race around the world, and I covered that stop last year. I covered the Miami stop and the finish in Galway, Ireland, and that's a really great race.
Okay.
And then I also shot the America's Cup match series in Newport last June. It was
okay.
So.
When you mentioned that you covered the certain stops, so you don't actually go 35,000 miles of follow.
I'd like to.
You don't.
And I've offered my services for that, but
so
I haven't.
So you kind of know when they're going to be in the at the harbor or the location, wherever they're supposed to be, and then you get there in time to go out and meet them as they come in, or
well,
how does
I'm
that
actually
work?
Invited to go by the press office of the regattas. They mm-hmm. asked me to come. Mm-hmm. Sometimes they sponsor my trip. Sometimes I go on my own, but they asked me to come. And these big regattas, there's a whole press center with 50 or 60 workstations for us press people, and they arrange for boats, and they arrange for food, and mm-hmm. they arrange for helicopters and all that type of stuff. So, mm-hmm.
Well, hold
organized.
That thought. We're going to talk about that a little bit more. But right now what I want to do is we have queued up a couple of your favorite mm-hmm. video segments that you've taped. And tell us the first one we're going to see. Tell us what that is.
The first one is a boat called Decision. It's a 40-foot car keek. I did this video with a GoPro in Key West in January, this recent past January, and it's one of my clients that I shoot for, and it's a great video. It's a great regatta down in Key West I cover every year.
Okay. Now, before we start it, I want to do one thing. I know what a GoPro is,
okay.
But for the benefit of our viewing audience, tell us what a GoPro is.
It's a small, high-def camera. And usually if I'm racing or if I'm on a boat, I wear it here. We might be able to get one between the break so we can show mm-hmm. show the audience. Okay. But I have a bunch of them, and I use them a variety of ways. I strap them to my chest when I race. I put them on a long pole. I dunk them in the water. I mount them on mast. I mount them on the back of the boat. They're pretty neat cameras, and then I can edit all the okay. stuff together.
So if the viewers will see a camera which seems to be disassociated from a human body, they'll know that that was taken with this remote, with this camera
yeah.
that you can actually attach to a long pole
right.
or up the mast or, yeah. or different unique situations.
I was one of the first to start using GoPro in sailing.
Exactly. And yeah. I think you turned BevCam on, and we've yeah. used a GoPro a right. couple of times mm-hmm. Recently. So let's queue up the video and watch. What are we watching
Decision.
Now?
Decision.
Decision.
In Key West.
Okay.
I'm running out of ways to try and reach you, and every day I'm torn back by a lost fire. The hotter I submit, the pulls me farther out to sea. And now I've lost my horizon. Must I trust the stars to navigate me home tonight? I pray for tidal waves to bring me back to safe shores.
Wow, exciting stuff, Leighton.
Thank you.
Now, this was Decision 2013. That was just this year.
Key West.
And is the Decision the name of the boat or the name of the race?
It's name of the boat. It's the Key West Race Week, which I cover every year.
Okay. Yeah. Now, that was some exciting footage. Were you actually a member of the crew, or you were just the photographer?
No, I was the hired media help.
The hired media help.
Right.
Okay. And how long a race is this?
Well, it races every day.
Oh, okay.
So it's 5 days of racing. The races, there's two or three races a day, okay. And the races can be anywhere from 60 minutes to 120 minutes, 2 hours.
Okay, and there are different classes of boats.
Correct. There's about 10 different classes.
Classes of boats. Okay.
Three different lines.
Okay.
Yeah.
Now, I know you have in your hand here what's called the GoPro.
Right.
And I'd like to see if we could get if Steve could get a close-up of that, if you hold it still. And tell us a little bit about the things that you can do with this kind of a camera.
The GoPro does both video and stills, high def. It has a couple different cases. This should be a commercial for them, right? And some of the cases are watertight. Some of the cases are open, so you get better sound. I wear it strapped to my chest with a different kind of mount if I'm actually racing, so my hands are free to pull lines and that type of thing. And then I put it on a long monopole so I can hold it off the boat. I also, when it's on my chest, I can pull it off my chest and frame shots. Mm-hmm. I don't use GoPro like other people use GoPro. Usually they just attach them to something and let it run. I tend to do short little clips, and then I edit the clips together with mm-hmm. the music like you saw.
Yeah, very convenient. It's very small, and as you say, you can strap it on, and your hands are free to do other things. Very good, very nice, very convenient little gizmo. And as I say, we have you to thank for BevCam's usage of that in a few productions we've done recently. Now, Leighton, you mentioned that you sometimes have tourism boards or boat sponsors or race sponsors get in touch with you, and that has a lot to do with your social media and your website. Tell us a little bit about that.
A couple years ago, probably about 4 years ago, a gentleman turned me on to kind of social media, and he said, you should really be on Facebook. And with high-tech stuff, when I get on, it's just bang, bang, bang. I really get on it. So I got on Facebook. I got on Twitter. Recently, a year ago, I got on Instagram. I have a couple blogs, a bunch of Twitter accounts. And I learned how to do social media live from my iPhone. And I built up a following of 25,000 people. So a couple of years ago, people recognized that I had quite a following in the sailing community, and tourism boards got interested in getting me into their locations during races. So a lot of times when I go to traveling someplace, my trip is sponsored by the Division of Tourism because they want me to go and post beautiful images and videos and say nice things about their venue, such as St. Thomas has been a gig for me for 3 years. The BVI's is a new gig for me. They had me come in this year. Mm-hmm. I've been to Corpus Christi for an assignment. So that's how I'm doing these trips these days.
Not very boring, is it? and of course, the sponsors of the race take advantage of the fact that you have so many followers, so they instantly multiply you by all these thousands of people that follow you, so they get a lot of publicity and a lot of promotion.
Yeah, they retweet my stuff, reblog it, re-Facebook it, and sometimes I can actually plug in their social media into my software and pump it out to their following, too.
Oh, wonderful. Yeah. Now, we have another video that we've queued up, and so tell us what we're going to be looking at now.
This is Synergy. This was done in photographed in St. Thomas, the Rolex Regatta. And I do this regatta 3 years. I've been doing this. And Synergy is a Russian boat, and they've actually hired me a few times at different regattas to do video and stills.
All right, so this is the Rolex Regatta on the boat called Synergy.
Synergy, and it's a Melges 32. This was an interesting ride because the only one who spoke English on the boat was an Italian guy who was running the boat, and everybody else was Russian. And so it was kind of interesting because, sometimes they have to communicate with their hands to tell me where to go.
Well, I hope they communicated politely.
Oh, they did. Yeah,
and what year was this taken?
This was this year.
This year. Okay. Yeah. So this is Synergy, the Rolex Regatta on the Russian boat
Russian
Synergy.
Melges 32.
Okay. There we go.
Think I'm running out of ways to try and reach you, and every day I'm torn back by your lies. For the harder I submit, the bones we fall around to see. And
long. By the time you read this, I'll be gone as long as memory allows me. You've been my world.
My world.
Wow, Leighton, that is wonderful videography. That is exciting stuff. You know, I remember watching video footage and films of races, and you'd kind of see the boats off in the distance, and you really didn't get the feel. I mean, here you really get the feel that you can feel the wind and the waves. You feel like you're right in the cockpit of the boat. Very clever, very exciting. Now, also, tell us a little bit. That music was just perfectly appropriate. Tell us about
local band, Autumn Above, autumnabove.com.
Give them a little plug.
Chris Harvey. He's actually a local musician who's in a couple bands, mm-hmm. and I actually race with his mother, Cheryl Harvey. It's all one big happy family.
Fantastic. Yeah. Now, also, we have been switching the scenes in back of us, and I wanted to also make mention of that. These are some of your still images.
Correct.
Tell us a little bit about
the
those.
First one was of the match series, America's Cup match series in Newport. The second one was of the 32nd America's Cup in Valencia, Spain. That was one of my first real world-class regattas that I shot, and I did quite a bit of work from a helicopter. That was back in 2008 or 9. And then this image behind us now is from Newport from, I believe it was the end of June, the AC45 series, which is the match racing to find out the qualifiers for the America's Cup.
Mm-hmm. Now, you've shown us a couple of kind of exotic locales. Any mm-hmm. other exciting kinds of places that you have been to covering regattas?
Well, I've been to, I mentioned Key West. This year I went to St. Martin for the Heineken Regatta. And I also went to St. Thomas again. And then from St. Thomas I went over to the BVI's Tortola for another regatta.
Mm-hmm. And we mentioned before, and I want our audience to really appreciate this fact. Now, these boats that we're seeing pictures of, mm-hmm. are the boats and the regattas that you have covered and that you tape and film are actually the kind of boats that you would see in the America's Cup races. Is that tell
some
us
of
a little
them
about
are.
That? Yeah,
some are professional, some are amateur. Mm-hmm. It's kind of a real mix.
Mm-hmm. And who sponsors or who owns these boats? Is it like corporations or individuals? Or tell us a little bit about that.
Larry Ellison owns all the Oracle boats and pretty much the races. but they're private owners, most of them, and it's most of them are what called Corinthian racing, which is unsponsored racing. So. Millionaires with lots of money and some time on their hands and some big egos.
I guess that would exclude me.
Me too.
exciting. Now, I think you have one more clip that we're gonna watch. Tell us a little bit about what we're going to see.
This is the Blue Peter, which is a boat built in 1930. It's been restored a few times. This was down in the BVI Spring Regatta. It was the second day of racing. We raced to another island. We actually won this one.
Mm-hmm.
Very beautiful boat. This video is a little bit different style for me. I really haven't done something like this before, but it's a little bit more relaxing and soothing, so grab a blanket and a pillow for this one.
Okay, and BVI is British Virgin Islands.
British Virgin Islands.
Yeah. Okay, so here is, I want you to introduce it for us now.
Blue Peter and the British Virgin Islands, and we're racing to, I believe it was Peter Island.
Okay, here we go.
Yeah, we won.
All right, here we go. Thank you. Wow, that was very nice, very idyllic. I kind of got the feeling that the tempo and the music, it didn't feel as if, like the first clips, like they were really racing, right. But this was a race.
Oh, those were definitely a race.
Definitely a race, but the feeling was a little more, more laid back.
Right.
And tell us a little bit more about this boat. You say it was built in the 30s and restored?
30s, restored a bunch of times. It made it through a couple World Wars, I guess.
Yeah.
And, this guy bought it about 10 years ago and decided to charter it and race it.
Yeah. I especially like some of your low angle shots where you seem to have the camera like almost down on the wave tops. Tell us how did you get those shots?
Oh, I put it on a pole and I make sure it's in the watertight case, and then I just put the pole over with my hand and put it really close to the water or hold it out so I can get the crew.
Yeah. Yeah. You really love doing this, don't you?
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, and it really is a dream job for you, isn't it, as we spoke about earlier?
Yeah, it's more of a passion than a job.
Yeah, that's right, exactly. But you're making money at it, so...
A little.
Now, tell us, in all of your sailing adventures and racing and filming regattas, any kind of very interesting moments or any scary moments, any close calls that you can recall?
I had a scary moment in St. Thomas about a month ago when I was on a photo boat and the bridge started to break away, and the captain of the boat decided he wanted to tie it down and hold it off, and I refused. I put away my gear and I refused, and I said, this is unsafe, it's going to fall, I want to go back on the shore.
Wow.
That was a little bit scary.
I'll bet, yeah. And when you say the bridge was breaking
away?
Well,
there's a metal structure that holds the radar and the fishing poles and antennas, and it had come loose from the welds.
I see, okay.
And pounding on the waves, one end came right off the end of the boat, and I said, this is unsafe, I need to go back.
Okay.
A little bit of a prima donna sometimes.
Now, you have a website.
Right.
If people want to get in touch with you or if they want to watch some of your videos, tell us about that.
My website is leightonoconnor.com, and I think they're going to put it on the screen. And my YouTube channel, which is all free, is you just search for Leighton O'Connor, or the handle is Leighton OC, and that's my handle for my Facebook and my Twitter and my Instagram and a bunch of other social media accounts.
Okay, and you have these videos that we've been watching today on these sites.
There's about 40 videos on there.
Okay, very good.
Yeah.
Well, Leighton O'Connor, it's been a pleasure
to have you on
North Shore Journal, and we'll wish you a bon voyage the next time you're overseas and racing, and drop us a quick note and let us know. And
I will.
All right. Well, thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
And we've had a nice interview today with Leighton O'Connor, and you've been watching North Shore Journal, and we'll see you next time. Hi, everybody. Welcome to another edition of North Shore Journal. I'm your host, Walt Kosmowski, and I have a very special guest with me today. Yes, his name... Let's start there.
How special is he?
This is a comedy
show. he's so special, I can't remember his name. And I got to look at my piece of paper.
Let's try that again.